9.1 is underway, and we all just want one thing, right? We want that juicy rating. And if you want to farm this season, stick around, because we will be breaking down the best 3v3 comps for 9.1. But before we get into it, we have a quick question for you. What rating are you trying to push this season? Maybe you want to break that 1800 barrier, or maybe you want to push all the way to Gladiator. Let us know what your ambitions are for Season 2. And if you want the best chance at reaching your goals, consider checking out skillcapped.com/wow. But you might be wondering, what does Skillcapped offer that I can't get someplace else? Glad you asked. Our website features the biggest collection of arena commentaries on the internet, where pro players break down arena games step by step, showing you exactly how they win matchups that you might be struggling with. And for as low as $4.99 a month with a money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. So if you want to gain rating and hit your goals this season, check out Skillcap today. The gods of Season 1 are still doing well this patch, but there are some new god slayers in the mix. Arms Warriors are arguably the best DPS class in the game right now, and Resto Shamans might actually be the best healer. So when you combine these classes together, you have the makings for some S-tier comps. Shadow Priests might be the best caster in the game, and Red Paladins remain one of the strongest hybrids. When you pair all of these classes together, you have what it takes to dominate the ladder. Both WPS and Ret Warrior are really strong comps, dealing some of the highest consistent damage in the game, while being able to fall back on hybrid utility as a defensive tool. These defenses come in handy against our next S-tier comp, which is RMP. Even though sub-rogues and fire mages saw some minor nerfs in the patch, this comp continues to do well at multiple rating levels in the bracket. Its ability to instantly reverse pressure with cross CC and stun setups allows it to remain competitive against every comp in the game. This means RMP can adapt to the meta no matter how fast or slow games play out, keeping it at god-tier status for the remainder of this season. And finally, making its sweet return in Season 2 is Jungle Cleave. Beast Mastery Hunters and Feral Druids both saw some pretty significant buffs in 9.1, keeping this comp elevated to S-tier status. BM Hunters still remain incredibly difficult kill targets, being able to remove win conditions from many comps due to their feigned death legendary. Combined with the damage and off-healing of a Feral Druid, this comp can be incredibly tanky, all while dealing huge consistent damage from both DPS classes. With the Season 2 gods established, we have some comps that almost made it to the S tier. Starting off, we have some Mage Spell Cleaves, with both Ellie Mage and God comp doing really well in the meta. Although Fire Mages are strong on their own, having the support of the two best hybrid casters definitely elevates them to another level, allowing these comps to compete against many of the high tiers. Two Warrior Melee Cleaves barely missed the cut for S tier, with Windwalker Warrior Shaman and non-shaman variants of Ret Warrior making our A+ tier. Once again, Warriors remain a backbone to many strong comps, having enough defensive tools to build an entire lineup around. With the assisted pressure from Windwalkers and the utility of Ret Paladins, these melee cleaves are seeing massive success during early Season 2. Our Survival Hunter friends will be happy to know that Survival Jungle Cleave is also in contention as a god-tier comp. Though it lacks the same consistent pressure as BM, survival damage is still quite high, and with the added utility of multiple snares and mending bandage as coverage against assassination rogues, this cleave is really competitive in Season 2. And speaking of melee cleaves, some comps are building themselves around Demon Hunters after they received huge buffs in 9.1. Both DH DK and DH Windwalker Resto Shaman are doing really well in the early stages of this season. Their primary strength is just how good they are at disrupting casts, being able to shut down many caster melee teams with relative ease. That is on top of their insane burst damage, which is unmatched by almost every other comp. And while we're on the topic of Demon Hunters, many A-tier comps are also building themselves around this class. DH Ellie Shaman and Ret DH are incredibly formidable comps, having huge raw throughput combined with added team utility. There are some weaker DH comps in the A-tier, with DH Fire Mage and Warrior DH, both of which are still able to compete against the high tiers. Some Ret Paladin Cleaves are also performing well this season, with Ret Windwalker, Ret Hunter, and Ret Feral all being solid picks. Windwalker and BM Hunter damage pairs really well with Ret Burst, while Ret Feral now presents itself as a tankier niche pick now that Druids have a Mortal Strike effect with Wicked Claws. And speaking of Mortal Strike, Warriors continue to be the backbone of many A-tier comps, with Thundercleave and TSG both being super durable, pressure-centric lineups. For TSG, it is highly recommended to play with the Kyrian Warrior with the new Elysian Might Legendary, since it gives the comp a really consistent win condition, preventing teams from kiting out of Spear of Bastion. Turbo Cleave and Kitty Cleave are also solid choices for Warriors, both being relatively tanky and built around outlasting their opponents with consistent pressure. Bridging the gap between Cleves is WMP, a comp that is consistently played by many tournament teams. Just like any Warrior teams, this comp relies on dealing consistent pressure while falling back on powerful defensive options. Pair that with the damage and control of a Fire Mage, and the comp is still able to compete at the highest level. And speaking of mages, there are a few mage teams that have also made it to our A tier this season. Shatterplay, Windwalker Mage, FMP, and RMPala continue to be solid picks in the meta. The common thread between all these comps is the ability to assist the mage with setups, each having a few different stun options to streamline kill attempts as a team. Moving down to the B tier, we have a few comps built around Windwalker Monks, pairing them with Frost DKs, Enhancement Shamans, and Balance Druids. Windwalker DK has lost a bit of steam since last season, as DKs are starting to slip further behind other melee. Enhanced Windwalker is a setup that did really well in the first weeks of the season, as its combined burst damage was more than enough to quickly finish off games within a few seconds. Windwalker Boomy definitely has potential, but it is a pretty difficult comp to play. Balanced Druids pump out damage better than most classes, but often struggle when trained the entire game. And speaking of Boomkins, there are some B-tier comps that can build around the spec. Boomkin Ellie Shaman, Boomy DH, and Boomy Shadow Priest. Once again, Balanced Druids typically struggle when trained, while lacking damage outside of cooldowns to truly finish out games. Playing with an Ellie Shaman, DH, or Shadow Priest really helps mitigate that problem, as all of these classes are able to support with pressure even when the Druid is locked down. The strength of Shadow Priest in the current meta has also allowed some creative team building, with Shadow Priest Demon Hunter being a niche comp going into 9.1. Now that Demon Hunters have a more reliable healing reduction effect, they are able to better support their team with the added consistency of Shadow Priest's Silence Horror kill setups. RPS and FPS continue to be decent picks for Shadow Priest, though being weaker than their warrior alternatives. Both of these setups rely on the consistent damage from both Assassination Rogues and Feral Druids, gradually rotting the enemy team down in between CC setups. And you didn't think we forgot about Warlocks, right? Unfortunately, Locks aren't dominating exactly like we thought, but each spec has at least one B-tier comp to compete with the high tiers. For Affliction, it means pairing with a Demon Hunter, since their healing reduction and consistent damage synergize well with AoE pressure. For Demo, the best comp might actually be with the BM Hunter, due to the reworked Beast Within talent, which buffs all nearby pet damage. If there was any time for a Zoo Cleave in WoW, the time is now. Finally, for Destruction Warlocks, both MLD and Shadow Play are probably your best options. Admittedly, these comps might be a bit too slow for the current meta, but later on in the season when players are a bit tankier, these might actually become high tier. For the meantime, the raw power of melee is really holding back the experimentation of Warlock-based spell cleaves. Speaking of being held back, Mistweaver Monk Cleaves are also stuck on the B tier for now. Both Turbo Cleave and TSG work well for Mistweavers, but aren't nearly as strong compared to other healers. Monks still seem to be struggling with healing output, making them less valuable in a damage-centric meta. If things slow down a bit, this could change, but for now, they are convincingly mid-tier. Finally, for all of our hipsters out there, we have some underdog comps to fill out the meta, starting with Arcane Shatterplay. Arcane mages are pretty underwhelming this season, having very few true kill options outside of a gimmicky Arcanosphere. This forces them to play with classes like Shadow Priests, who are able to win games on their own. Fury Warriors are also a bit underwhelming, being a bit more bark than bite in Season 2. Although they have a healing reduction effect, they lack the true tankiness and utility as their arms counterpart, though still performing okay with most of the standard warrior cleaves. Outlaw is starting to see more experimentation, and if you want to try it out in 3v3, we highly recommend playing RMP or RMPala. One advantage of Outlaw in the current meta is the Float Like a Butterfly PvP talent, allowing them to get a much shorter cooldown on evasion to avoid melee damage. Finally, rounding out the C tier is Marksmanship Hunter Jungle Cleave. Marks really took a fall from grace from the early stages of the expansion, and with buffs to BM and survival, it has really fallen behind its other specs. With that in mind, Jungle Cleave is still your best option since it has most of the tools as its BM version, just with significantly less consistent damage. Here we have a complete picture of the 3v3 meta in the first half of Season 2. One thing you should immediately notice is that Demon Hunters are filling in the spots of many high-tier comps. This is entirely due to their rework in 9.1, as their healing reduction effect became more reliable when they got some damage increases across the board. Fire mages and arms warriors continue to do well, often complementing many of the high-tier melee and casters from our latest tier list updates. To the surprise of many, resto shamans are exceeding expectations in the early stages of Season 2, being largely considered one of the best offensive healers while being able to fall back on a seemingly infinite mana bar. Priests, druids, and paladins continue to do well, but require very specific comps in order to compete in this melee-dominant meta. Not all hope is lost for our low tiers, as there is certainly a role for every spec in the game. With more experimentation, we could see increasing numbers of warlocks as well as outlaw rogues if people are willing to go against the grain. In any case, the strength of the many comps right now depends on how well they can deal with a fast-paced melee meta, while also having the ability to counter the newly added Shackles trinket. And that wraps up our 3v3 roundup for the first half of Season 2. If you are looking to push raiding this season, be sure to check out skillcap.com/wow, where we will be adding more and more content for this new season. As always though, thanks for watching, see you guys soon.